Hello, and welcome back to another week at Tiger TV. I'm Clay Evans.
And I'm Addie Hinkey. This week, something very strange is happening in Germany, as an ice cream parlor has invented a new flavor, cricket ice cream. And it even has dried brown crickets on top. Sounds pretty good, huh?
Absolutely delicious.
Now let's send it to McKaylee to give us a recap of this week's sports.
Thanks, guys. We kicked off our spring sports last week. With track starting, we have a lot of people out for it. As of right now, we have 34 kids for junior high and 31 kids for high school. For baseball, we have 12 kids out. And for boys golf, there is 5. Good luck to our Tigers starting spring sports. And don't forget the dual credit speech classes are doing a dodgeball tournament this Friday at 6 p.m. in the elementary gym. The deadline for the sign-up team is tomorrow at 3 p.m. Contact Faith Stamer or Carsey Brown to sign up. Back to you guys.
Thanks, McKaylee. Now let's head over to our weekly weather report with Lauren.
Thanks, guys. Today, the high is supposed to be 45 with a low of 32 and partly cloudy. Wednesday, it'll be cloudy with a high of 40 and a low of 33. Thursday, the high is going to get up to 38 with a low of 33 and a chance of rain. Friday, it'll be cloudy with a high of 41 and a low of 27. Saturday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 40 and a low of 31. Sunday, it is supposed to be cloudy with the temperature reaching up to 28 and the low being 26. That's all for this week. Back to you guys in the studio.
Great job, Lauren. Now Megan Spencer is going to give us an update on this week's Tiger organizations.
Thanks, guys. It's been a super busy time for our Tiger organizations. And continuing with that theme, here's what's going on this week. On March 23rd, the art department will be hosting their reading walkthrough. It will be jungle theme. NHS will be sponsoring another blood drive on March 15th from 2 to 5 p.m. in the Stacy Center Gym. All donors will receive a free t-shirt and have their name put in a drawing for a $25 Casey's gift card. Every unit that they collect helps them earn scholarship money for one of our seniors. So please come and help our NHS chapter meet their goal. Moving on, we want to wish the girls that are competing in state FCCLA star events on March 12th through the 14th good luck. Our Science Olympiad team recently competed in a regional competition. In the junior high regional competition, Haley Hine and Randy Wilson got second in Fast Facts. Ellie Gilkey, Randy Wilson, and Maddox Tipton won the Codebuster competition. For the high school division, Colby Hagen and Andrew Gunderson competed in a bridge competition. Connor Tudine and Seth Wethington competed in the forensic contest. Colby Hagen and Connor Tudine won the disease detective events. Great job, Tigers, and good luck to those moving on to state. Miss Schrader and the Scholar Bowl team will be competing versus Milan and South Harrison here at Princeton on March 13th. The games will begin at 4 p.m. in the high school library. Make sure you show up to support our Scholar Bowl teams. Lastly, our FFA has been working on their leadership and career development events. They'll compete at Grundy on the 6th, Gallatin on the 8th, and Lathrop on the 13th. Ag classes also will be having a speaker from the Welding Institute come and speak to their 8th hour class on March 7th. Thanks, guys. Back to you.
Thanks, Megan. Now for this week's current event, we'll send it over to Marie Walker.
Currently, there are many protests going against the Willow Project. You may be asking what the Willow Project is. Well, the Willow Project is the single largest oil extraction project proposed on federal lands, estimated to add more than 250 million metric tons of CO2 to the atmosphere over the next 30 years, equivalent to the emissions from 66 coal-fired power plants. With plans calling for up to 250 wells, 37 miles of road, 389 miles of pipeline, airstrips, and a new central processing facility to be built, the Willow Plan would contribute more greenhouse gas emissions than any other proposed project on Americans' public lands. In February of this year, the Department of Interior's latest announcement approved the construction of the proposed Willow Project. Though with this news out, it does not mean any final decisions as of yet. With all the controversy surrounding this, petitions have been made and have currently reached 1.2 million signs. If we are not careful, we could completely decimate our ecosystems. You can sign the petition at change.org. Back to you guys at the studio.
Thanks, Marie. Now we'll send it over to Jaylee Beach for this week's Tiger Spotlight.
Hey Tigers, it's Jaylee with Ms. Schrader and some of our students. We're here in the library, and this week we're going to let Ms. Schrader take the wheel and tell us a little bit about Scholar Bowl. I understand y'all are going to do a demonstration?
Yes. I've got my Scholar Bowl team, my starters of Seth Wethington, Colby Hagen, Sage Tudine, and Kenny Wright. They are going to do a mock game against my volunteers of Jay Allen, Talon Holt, Kelby Thomas, and John Treffler. Nico Rubio here is going to be my timer and my button clear. What we do in Scholar Bowl is we take trivia, whether it is from current events or history or literature or science or math or geography or mythology. We've got many different topics to choose from, and you're asked to answer these questions within 5 seconds. If you can, you buzz in. And your team, if you answer correctly, gets a chance at 3 bonus questions. I'm going to give you a sample of what this looks like. Okay, we've got a toss-up question, and the question category is current events. This agency has been criticized for using outdated legacy systems, such as the individual master file. Since 2018, Charles Rettig has served as the commissioner of this agency, which uses documents called W-2 and Form 1040. For 10 points, name this federal agency. Kenny.
The IRS.
The IRS, that is correct. Your bonus category is popular culture. The third game in this series, which is set on its protagonist's island homeland of Medici, introduced the wingsuit. For 10 points each, name this Avalanche Studios series starring the mercenary Rico Rodriguez, who overthrows dictators with the help of his grappling hook and parachute.
Just Cause.
That is correct. Part B. The first 2 Just Cause games were published by Eidos Interactive, which in 2009 was purchased by this Japanese developer of the Dragon Quest and Final Fantasy games.
Square Enix.
That is correct. Eidos also published this series of games about the archaeologist Lara Croft.
What is it? Oh, Tomb Raider.
That is correct. All right. As you can see, Kobe and Seth are captains on those bonus questions. They could be answered as the group, but Kobe had to be our spokesperson for it. Okay, let's give you one more toss-up to see how this goes. And go history for a toss-up. In 1969, police assassinated the chair of this organization's Illinois chapter, Fred Hampton. Eldridge Cleaver served as a spokesman for this party, which Bobby Seale and Huey P. Newton founded in Oakland in 1966. For 10 points, what leftist black... Seth.
Black Panther Party.
The Black Panther Party is correct. And for your bonus... Miscellaneous. Okay. For 10 points each, name these apps owned by Meta Platforms, which was formerly known as Facebook. In 2012, Facebook bought this popular photo sharing app. It introduced the Stories feature to compete with Snapchat.
Instagram.
That is correct. Part B. Meta also owns this messaging app with over 2 billion active users. It has been criticized for being a source of misinformation in Latin America and South Asia.
What's up?
That is correct. Part C, another Meta holding in this database that enables users to send silent looping videos through Facebook and other apps.
GIF.
Can you spell that?
GIF.
Incorrect. Rebound. Time?
Time's up.
Time's up. It's Giphy, and it's spelled G-I-P-H-Y.
Ah.
All right. That's it. Thank you.
All right. That's all we have for this week. Thank you, and thank you guys for taking this time out of your day. Back to you guys at the studio.
Thanks, Jaylee. To end this week's episode, we'll play a game of Guess That Celebrity with Gracie Mitchell.
Hey guys, Gracie Mitchell here, and for this week's game, we're going to be playing Guess the Celebrity. Do you know who this is?
The guy from Riverdale?
Yeah. Do you know who this celebrity is?
It's Jennifer Aniston.
Good job. Do you know who this celebrity is?
I do not.
Katy Perry. Do you know who this is?
Gabby something.
That's right. Gabby Douglas.
Yeah.
Do you know who this is?
No.
He didn't even look.
I still don't know, so.
Do you know who this is?
It's either Dua Lipa or Demi Lovato.
Katy Perry. Do you know who this is?
AJ Kappa.
Yeah. Do you know who this is?
Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah. That's it for this week. Back to you guys.
Awesome job, Gracie. We'd like to wish a happy birthday this week to Lincoln Bent, LaKaylin Galloway, Max Walkup, Marin Illig, Cassie Alderson, Marcus Simpleton, and Andrew Rhodes. Happy birthday, guys.
That's it for this week.
We hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Tiger TV. Have a great week.
Stay classy, Princeton.
Okay. This player's nickname, Charlie Hustle, referred to his tendency to run to first base after being walked.
Pete Rose.
That is correct.
Yeah.
Hey. Your bonus question. Your bonus category, I'll be kind and not choose mathematics. Your bonus question. Okay. Let's go fine arts. Okay. In the theater, this common verb denotes the practice of announcing cues over headset during a play for 10 points each. A, give this verb that precedes board or sheet to name the posted list that indicates actors' attendance for performances or rehearsals.
Would.
Incorrect. Rebound.
Cast.
Incorrect. It was call or calling.
Oh, okay. Call.
Okay, bonus B. The person who calls a show's cues and sets up the call board is typically this theatrical employee who, along with the director, oversees rehearsals and records notes. You can talk with each other. Time. Oh. You gotta get it within that 10 seconds.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
Rebound.
Assistant director.
Incorrect. It was the stage manager. Okay. Bonus part C. This other type of call occurs when someone makes an appearance on stage after the cast bows, usually for additional applause.
The Jiggy Man.
Incorrect. Mm. Rebound.
Encore.
Incorrect. It's called a curtain call.
It's called.
Call. We were looking for call. Okay. Isn't this fun? You're not
pulling it? I'm just stumped on that one.